now we can also get you into some meetings.
We have another 10 minutes or so. It's pretty brief, but we can take a few questions and then we answer questions throughout the day.
Yeah. Any questions?
Yeah. Why is the fuel economy on the Beetle TDI less than the Jet and Exot?
It has to do with the vehicle shape, the aerodynamics of the vehicle. That's probably the main issue driving that. It has a little bit to do with the gearing that is there. The gear is on the Beetle versus the gearing on the Jetta or the gearing on the Passat. But you do get these slight variations. Okay. Yes?
How many Golf R's would be available?
This iteration of Golf R, this A6 platform of Golf family, will be 5,000 units. And they'll be sold across the 2012 model year, 2013 model year, and then we'll have a new generation of Golf coming.
Any plans for a plug-in electric?
We'll talk about that at the ERL. They're going to go through our whole e-mobility position and strategy, I believe, with you. So I'll leave that one for there. So it'll be a much fuller response than my little clip.
What percentage of the Passat sales are TDIs?
The TDI, we have planned around plus or minus 20%. Take rate on Passat from a production standpoint for TDI. Our actual business case for TDI is built around a percentage that's lower than that, but it certainly has been one of our fastest moving engine offers for Passat. So we continue to look at have the production capability should we need it to take that even higher.
So are you capacity constrained on the diesel engines?
Not any more on Passat than we are for the entire portfolio. Right. So, you know, the global issues with our TDI engine supply.
And where are those engines built? Are those in Mexico? Or those
TDI engines come from Europe. I can get you the exact factory later today.
Are there some regions that you would like to be doing better in the U.S. market?
Sorry, say again.
Are there some regions within the U.S. market that you would like to be doing better? Are there some?
Historically, our sales, I mean, not counting the growth of the last 2 years, let's say, we've been in the Smile States. We've been from the West Coast down through the Southern, back up the East Coast. But I think what speaks to our overall growth is the opening up of a fifth region. So now our growth isn't just the Smile. We needed a fifth region to deal with the middle of the country, not just Texas. So our strength, we see our strength in all the regions. Proportionally, we remain the highest in the Smile where we were, but the growth we've seen, the 40% this year, 26%, 40% the year before that, has been in all regions equal.
You didn't mention South America.
No,
and
I mean,
you're strong in Brazil.
Yes, yes, we are. In our US market, we're Tim mentioned our market shares. I mean, I know having worked in all of the Americas before I came to the Volkswagen world, and that's a little in the back of my head always thinking, how can we, you know, with our 2018 goals, I mean, we're working to get closer and closer to some of the major markets for Volkswagen in terms of pure volume, where we would be closer in annual volume to Brazil than we are now. But we, in Volkswagen of America, we don't have any direction or setting of strategy for the rest of the Americas. We only work with our Canadian colleagues, and we of course work with the Mexican market because they are receiving the same product we are receiving, be it out of Puebla, or out of Wolfsburg, or out of Chattanooga.
Okay. 90%
market share. Any talks of bringing the Scirocco to the U.S. market?
I think our CEO has talked about that at some of the auto shows. We have an overall portfolio strategy where we have a plethora of possibilities that could come to the U.S. market, and you know, that's one of them, but no firm action on it. Yeah.
Add that.